One of the greatest things about being a sports fan is all the history that comes with it. The moment you first turn on a game or you sit down with your dad to watch his team that quickly becomes your team, you become part of all this history. And the end of a decade is the perfect time to look back on a bit of that history. This is a video about the history of this decade. Now, to be clear, this is all influenced by my own perceptions and my own memories, and I was 14 in 2010. So, opinions may differ, and if they do, please let me know. Let's discuss in the comments or on Twitter. But at the end of the day, I believe this is what people will remember from 2010 through 2019. This is the 10 most influential athletes from this decade. Let's begin with some honorable mentions. I'll use this section to note this is a list about the athletes I've perceived to have changed the conversation about sports in this decade. So this isn't me ranking the best athletic accomplishments or the best athletes per se, although of course that plays a big part in it. So here are the men and women who have barely missed out on my final list. Usain Bolt became the fastest man on earth officially last decade, but his dominance continued to shock people through 2016. He completed his historic triple-triple gold medals, despite the fact one of the medals was stripped because someone on his relay team popped for drugs. His influence is diminished, frankly, because he does things we can't even put into words, so it's easier to just not talk about it than, you know, try to actually describe it all. Michael Phelps, another example of a guy whose major influence in sports actually started last decade. Of course, he deserves mention here because he finished off his legendary career as the most decorated Olympian in history, and he transformed himself after the controversy that surrounded him after the 2012 Olympics. He'll go down as one of the greatest athletes in history, and rightly so. Brittany Griner, pretty much the reason I included that line about this list not being about the best athletes. Griner is an absolutely shocking athletic talent. She was when she was in school at Baylor. She continues to be an athletic marvel in the WNBA. She may not have influenced the overall sports discussion like the rest of the athletes on the list, but man, has she shown herself to be a next-level athlete. In no particular order, let's get on to the list. Number 1, Junior Seau. Unfortunately, I have to start out with a sad entry here, but there's at least hope stemming from an unbelievably tragic situation. Seau was one of the greatest linebackers of his generation and earned a well-deserved reputation for playing hard and playing tough. The man barely missed a snap in his career. He finished in 2009 with nearly 2,000 career tackles, 56.5 sacks, and 18 picks. But in 2012, we received the shocking news that Seau took his own life. But as more information came out about the circumstances, it became clear Seau's situation was not just a case of mental illness and the what to do after football question. Concussions had already been a topic coming into that moment, but when it was revealed Seau shot himself in the chest, rather than the typical shot to the head that is common in gunshot suicides, it was revealed that Seau knew something was wrong in his head, and the multiple concussions he sustained from playing football were the cause. To his last breath, Seau wanted to save future football players from succumbing to what must have been a terrible lifestyle he led leading up to his death. The undeniable sadness of Seau's death led to a much wider conversation about concussions in football, and really in all of sports. It's tragic a man of Seau's character had to die before his time, but who knows how many lives his final decisions saved. Number 2. Phil Hughes. Okay, I lied, there's actually two sad entries to start out the list. But while Seau was the bigger story in the United States for weeks, and the lasting effects of his death are still a topic in American sports today, Phil Hughes' story went pretty much unnoticed, at least by American fans. Hughes was an up-and-coming cricket star for Australia, a player whose incandescent talent, even at such a young age, was the talk of the cricket world. But in 2014, just 5 days before his 26th birthday, during a test match, Hughes was struck in the back of the neck by a ball while he was batting. The ball was a bouncer, a kind of ball designed to bounce high and disrupt a batter who's crushing low balls. Hughes had forced 19 bouncers before that, but a slight miscalculation led the ball, which was traveling at 140 kilometers an hour, to hit Hughes in the back of the neck, causing a brain hemorrhage and eventually his death 2 days later. But like Seau, Hughes' death was followed by a bevy of conversation to improve the sport. Batter protection and improving the accuracy and safety of bouncers were forefront in the conversation. Also a main topic was the idea of sledging, what Americans would call trash talking. It was reported in the inquest following Hughes' death that a bowler reportedly told Hughes he would kill him during the match, an example of the sledging that's common in cricket. The conversation about the ethics of this practice has spanned years, and the tragedy of the situation has hardly left the minds of cricket fans all over the world. Number 3. Roger Federer. From a gentleman's game to the greatest gentleman in the game, Roger Federer has completely redefined how we view tennis players and the length of their careers. It's easy to forget, tennis players didn't used to go this deep into their lives at such an elite level. As a tennis player, your career began as a teenager and it was pretty much over in your mid-20s. For some of the legends, you could possibly push it into your early 30s, and for Jimmy Connors, even into his mid-30s. But you'd have to get lucky, and the next generation defining player can't have come around yet. At first, it seemed like King Roger was going to go down the very same path. As he got into his 30s, Federer started to uncharacteristically pull out of tournaments, retire from matches, take months off. Injuries were clearly taking their toll on Federer, who had already been playing pro tennis for a decade and a half. He was going to retire as probably the greatest of all time. He had already passed Pete Sampras as the most decorated tennis player of all time and became just the second player to surpass $100 million in career earnings. He could have walked away from the game as an immortal. Instead, here comes Roger at 34 years old with a reworked backhand and a powerful serve, who begins tearing up the tour like he had done years earlier. Instead of bowing out a legend, Federer gave himself a second career, and all of this in the most competitive age of male tennis ever. He added majors, masters titles, and Laver Cups to his already incomprehensible tally. He influenced the other legends of his time to do the same. As the most physical player in the game and clay court king, Rafa Nadal changed his game to ward off his own mounting injury problems. Where at one point it seemed Federer was destined to be passed by the younger, hotter Novak Djokovic, Federer has cemented himself as the greatest tennis player of all time, a man whose career could be split into two careers and he'd make the Hall of Fame in both. I didn't mean to gush over Roger, but he's such a likable person and such a legendary athlete, it's hard not to just sit back and be amazed at what he's done both on and off the court. Number 4. Serena Williams. Yes, two tennis players in the same video. It seems like the sport is a bit overrepresented when I'm only including 10 athletes, but be honest, does Serena not deserve to be on this list? As incredible and legendary as Roger Federer's career has been, it didn't really reach the mainstream American sports fandom. Serena's chase for 23 majors, though, absolutely did. People who had never watched a tennis match tuned in to watch Serena. She wasn't just the biggest female star in the sport, she was the biggest star, at least to American audiences. She started conversations about women versus men on the tennis court, as inaccurate as that may be. She's put together a legendary career, and while most of it came without the level of competition we see today, Serena is responsible, at least in part, for the growth in women's tennis worldwide. Number 5. Ronda Rousey. The first of what is going to be several controversial athletes that find a spot on this list, but Ronda is the perfect example of a crossover star. And not only was she a crossover star, she was the first crossover star in women's mixed martial arts. Before Ronda came along, women's mixed martial arts wasn't really on anyone's radar. Hell, women's combat sports in general weren't really in the conversation. Rowdy Ronda became a global superstar. My college roommate had a life-size poster of her in his room. She was a box office draw. Not a box office draw for a woman, just a box office draw, period. In losing, Ronda ushered in a new era of women's combat sports. She was the quintessential transition between adolescence and adulthood. We didn't need a pre-made superstar in women's MMA. Superstars could make themselves based on the same criteria by which male superstars make themselves. Ronda became a literal box office draw, acting in movies when previously even male MMA stars didn't have that level of mainstream appeal. When Rousey crossed over again to WWE, she became the biggest star in sports entertainment, yanking the spotlight onto the women of wrestling. You don't have to like her. I actually don't, given her actions after her first UFC loss. But she's done more for women's MMA and MMA in general than almost any athlete to ever do it. Number 6. Conor McGregor. Conor's story actually mirrors Rousey's in many ways. And if you thought people didn't like Ronda, just look at the discussion around Conor. But that was kind of the point. And what's lost in the discussion around Conor McGregor is how transcendent of an athlete he was inside the octagon. He became the first ever fighter to hold championships in two weight divisions simultaneously. He took down some of the greatest in the history of the sport. His fights were like Hollywood movies, drawing more eyes to the sport of MMA than anyone before him. His boxing match against Floyd Mayweather, as farcical as it may be to those of us who are more pure boxing fans, was the biggest event on earth when it happened. No one in the diehard MMA community likes Conor McGregor. I mean, no one. And I understand. He made the sport mainstream and brought in a chunk of uneducated fans that get involved in serious conversations. I try every day not to be part of that group. But at the end of the day, Rousey and McGregor both brought a sport that, less than 20 years earlier, was considered too brutal to even be televised to the forefront of the sporting world. Number 7. Colin Kaepernick. When it comes to topics that become the forefront of conversation, perhaps nothing was more spotlighted and controversial than Colin Kaepernick deciding to sit for the national anthem before a game in 2016. His transition to kneeling, followed by many athletes from many different sports doing the same, almost immediately transcended the sporting world. It made its way to the highest office in America as even President Donald Trump commented on the situation. It kickstarted conversations about the nature of political discussion in sport, which spanned every sport all over the world. By proxy, ESPN's coverage of the situation and the social media blowback to it brought the previous titan of sports coverage back to earth. Perhaps nothing has been more pervasive at the cross-section of sports and politics than Kaepernick kneeling, and, like it or not, it created conversations that we had never seen in sports before. Number 8. LeBron James. LeBron was more active in the discussion started by Colin Kaepernick than any player in the NBA, and his clashes with Laura Ingraham about the nature of athletes in the political discussion were front-page news for weeks. But that's actually not why he makes my list. LeBron is unquestionably the greatest basketball player of this generation, and possibly the greatest to ever play the game. And in doing so, he's brought the NBA into the next generation. Colin Coward has a quote I think perfectly sums up LeBron's influence on basketball. Quote, "Magic and Bird saved the game. Jordan made it global. LeBron made it mobile." LeBron is one of only a handful of global superstars in the game of basketball, and he's the only one to switch teams more than twice, at least that I can think of. His decision to join the Miami Heat in 2010 was a worldwide event. He returned to Cleveland and won the city its first major championship in 50 years. LeBron has taken the game of basketball into the social media age, where personal branding is more important on a business level than team success. Number 9. Michaela Maroney. Our penultimate entry is a heavier one, as it confronts a darker part of sports and culture none of us want to acknowledge. And Maroney is far from the only person to get involved in this particular movement. But I refuse to violate the rules of my own made-up list, so here we are. USA gold medal winning gymnast Michaela Maroney was at the forefront of the allegations against Michigan State and USA Gymnastics Dr. Larry Nassar, who was accused of sexually assaulting hundreds of his patients. Maroney was not the first to make an allegation, but she was the first to bring Nassar to court. She connected the gymnast's struggles to bring Nassar to justice to the larger Me Too movement. The public backlash that contributed to over 250 gymnasts speaking out and testifying against the disgusting actions of Nassar brought more light to an issue that has plagued sports for generations. Maroney isn't the only one, but someone who's willing to be the public face of a court case about a man that tried to destroy their life is certainly deserving of a place on this list. Number 10, Lionel Messi. We end this list with the most quote-unquote sports-focused entry. Messi has actually been remarkably quiet about many of the issues we've talked about that have affected sports. Instead, he's just completely transformed our view of soccer. Every so often an athlete comes along that puts up numbers so gaudy, it redefines how we look at numbers in the future. Usain Bolt and Wilt Chamberlain come to mind. Messi has done the same thing on the grandest stages on earth. His 91 goal 2012, 91! Is still considered the single most indescribable accomplishment I've seen in any sport. Messi ushered in a new era of football, leading Barcelona teams that completely changed the sport. He's bookended the decade by winning soccer's top individual prize and has doubled the record for the most Ballon d'Or trophies ever won by a single player. He's been so good, we look at 40 goal seasons as pedestrian because they'd be in the lower half of his goal tallies across his career. People who have never watched a single minute of a soccer match know who Lionel Messi is. He's a crossover star without ever crossing over into anything. For those of us who have gotten fatigued by sports and political news and the constant 24/7 style of social media when it comes to athletes, Messi has been a nearly perfect foil to all that. He's almost silent on social media. His soft-spoken nature, combined with his absolute titanic performances on the field, combining the qualities many of us have missed in sports in the era of social media. Messi is the greatest individual soccer player to ever play the game, and his global fame was built this decade. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for being with us for the past few months. I love making these types of videos, and I love revisiting the history we've lived over the last 10 years. Hopefully, I'm still here to make another one of these in 2029. Until then, have a terrific new year. Subscribe and check back with us in 2020 for more general admission sports. We appreciate you.